Disneyland is a paradox, because let's be honest, it can be miserable with long lines, expensive tickets, and kids having meltdowns. When our family went there a few years ago, my son Cooper later recalled the experience in our annual holiday card by recounting episodes of heatstroke and vomiting, followed by a long, silent car ride home. Yet he concluded his story by stating, quite sincerely, "We can't wait to go back." Why is this? How come when we look back on things like family vacations, we hardly remember the sad or stressful moments and instead recall the happy ones? One answer is laughter. It releases endorphins that allow us to endure and even triumph over negative emotions and pain. Laughter and the ability to find humor in bad situations is what can explain the Disney paradox. Laughter helps to make negative moments fade. But laughter's power extends well beyond making amusement parks tolerable. Studies show that it can increase creativity, improve health, and strengthen relationships, all of which can have a positive effect in the business world as well. First, let's look how humor enhances creativity. Psychologist Alice Eisen and her colleagues asked participants to watch a short video and then solve a classic creativity challenge, where people are given a candle, a box of tacks, and some matches, and then asked to attach the candle to the wall in such a way that the wax doesn't drip on the table below when the candle's lit. The answer is that you can use the box containing the tacks to hold the candle. Half of the participants watched a neutral video. The others watched a funny video. Only 20% of the participants in the neutral condition solved the problem, but 3/4 of those in the funny condition did. It's not that laughter made the second group smarter, it's that it allowed them to relax more and feel emotionally safer. Humor loosened up their mind and helped them to see connections they previously missed. Next, let's look at health. In one study, Michael Miller and his colleagues showed a set of participants 2 15-minute movie segments 48 hours apart. The first was a scene from the stressful war movie Saving Private Ryan, then 2 days later a clip from the humorous comedy Kingpin. The participants' blood flow was measured before the study and after each viewing session, with dramatic results. Blood flow decreased by 35% after the stressful clip and increased 22% after the funny one. Keep this in mind if your objective is a better immune system. Finally, let's look at relationships. Doris Bazzini and her colleagues recruited couples to participate in a study. They asked some of the couples to reminisce about the times when they laughed together. Other couples were asked to reminisce about shared memories that made them feel good about their relationship. At the end of the study, the researchers measured how satisfied the couples were in their relationship. The results showed that couples who recalled times when they laughed together were more satisfied than those who recalled shared positive memories. Laughing together made their hearts grow fonder. So why is humor so powerful? One reason is that laughter releases endorphins, which can increase pain tolerance. In one study, Robin Dunbar and his colleagues tested the pain threshold of participants by wrapping their arms in a tightening blood pressure cuff until the individual said they couldn't take it anymore. Then they showed participants video clips, half getting to see something funny and the other half a documentary. Pain tolerance increased by 10% for the funny viewers. So humor seems to make us more creative and healthier, and it helps us to develop stronger relationships. Now, this doesn't mean you should show clips from your favorite comedy to break up a tense meeting, but it does mean that leaders should allow humor to flourish whenever they can. Your teams will appreciate it. They may even say they can't wait to go back.